हेलो स्टूडेंट, आई एम हर्षिला दत्ते, सीनियर लेक्चरर ऑफ कंप्यूटर इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट। इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट यूनिट टू, सर्चिंग एंड सॉर्टिंग। लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द सर्चिंग टॉपिक। द यूनिट आउटकम्स ऑफ दिस यूनिट इज एक्सप्लेन द वर्किंग ऑफ द गिवन सर्च मेथड यूजिंग एन एग्जाम्पल। आफ्टर रनिंग यूनिट यू शुड गिव द आंसर ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन। These are the learning outcomes of this video. You should understand concept of linear search, working of linear search, example of linear search, time complexity of linear search, advantages and disadvantages of the linear search. So, what is searching? Searching is a process used to find the location of given element. So there are two types of searching, linear or sequential search and binary search. So let us understand the concept of linear search. Take a real-time example. If there is a queue of 10 person in front of you and you want to find your friend, take an example that is your friend name is Ram. You want to find a Ram from this queue. How you can find a Ram from this queue? We start comparing Ram image or Ram face with the first person in the queue. If it matches, then you find the Ram. Otherwise, you go to the next person, that is second person. Again, you compare. If you find, then successful. If not, you again go to the third person. Till now, you go to the last person of the queue for finding the Ram. So this is what the linear search. You find the element or linearly from the list. So let us understand the example. Find a 23 using the linear search from the following array. Here array of size 5 is given with the elements 45, 66, 88, 99 and 23. See, these all elements are not sorted. This is the unsorted array. So if you want to find 23 linearly, you can start comparing the number 23 from array's first location, that is 0th location, to last location, that is 4th location. So in solution, we first store the 23 value in so many variable. Here we use the x variable. So in pass 1, we compare x with the 0th location, that is 23 with the 45. Are they same? No. So we go to the next pass, that is pass 2. In pass 2, we compare x with the first location. So our number to be searched is the 23 and the element present at the first location is the 66. Are they same? No. So we go to the next pass, that is third pass. Again, we compare x with the element present at the second location. So, we compare 23 and 88. Are they same? No. So, we go to the next pass, fourth pass. In fourth pass, we again compare 23 with the element present at the third location, that is 99. Are they same? No. So, we go to the next pass. In fifth pass, we again compare 23 with the element present at the fourth location. The element present at the fourth location is a 23. And the number to be searched that we store in x is a 23. Are they same? Yes. So we found the number 23 at the fourth location. This is another example. This is the example of unsuccessful search. If you are doing the searching operation, there are only two outputs. Whether your search will be successful, whether your search will be unsuccessful. Successful means you found the element. Unsuccessful means you didn't found the element. So in previous example, we found 23 in same array. We found the 23 at fourth location. This is the example of successful search. And in this example, we are going to search the number 90. This is the example of unsuccessful search. Now let us see. To find the 90, we again store the 90 into the x and start the pass 1. In pass 1, we compare 90 with the element present at the 0th location. Are they same? No. Then we will go to the next pass, pass 2. Again, we compare 90 with the element present at the first location. Are they same? No. So, we go to the third pass. In pass 3, we again compare 90 with the element present at the second location. The element present at the second location is the 88. So, are they same? No. So, we again go to the next pass, that is pass 4. In pass 4, we again compare 90 with the element present at the third location. The element present at the third location is 99. Are they same? No. So, we go to the next pass, that is pass 5. We again compare 90 with the element present at the fourth location. So, element present at the fourth location is 23. Are they same? No. So, our search is unsuccessful because we reached the end of the list. Since end of the array or list is reached, therefore x is equal to 90 is not present in the array. Till now we have seen the successful search and unsuccessful search example. Now let us understand the working of the linear search. This is the pseudocode for the linear search. For linear search, this is the one procedure function. Here, we input the list, that is array, and the number to be searched, that is the value, to the function. For each element in the list, in the array, we compare, we match the items, means the element in the array with the value to be searched. If we found the equal items and value, then we return the items location. And our search is successful. Otherwise, we go to the next comparison. We repeat this same procedure till the end of the list. If till the end of the list we didn't find our element, match element, then we give the output that search is unsuccessful. Let us understand a more example how to write in your exam or for the linear search example. So if you want to find 99, this is the input array A of the size 5 and having the element 11, 77, 33, 99 and 44. If you want to find a 99, you can clearly see that 99 is present at the third location. But how you can write into the paper for your examination? So, in solution, we first store the 99 into some variable. Here we take the x variable. Then we start the passes. How many passes we require to find the 99? How many comparison? Passes nothing but the comparisons. So how many comparison you will require for the linear search to find 99? We compare first 99 with 0th location, first pass. Again, then first location, second pass. Again with the second location, third pass. Again with the third location, so fourth pass. So how many passes you require? 1, 2, 3 and 4. So, let us start with the pass 1. X is equal to A of 0. If X is equal to A of 0, what is X? 99. What is A of 0? A of 0 is the 11. The element present at the 0th location is the 11. Are they equal? No. So, we go to the next pass, pass 2. Again, we compare X with the next location. In pass 1, we compare with the 0th location. So, in pass 2, we will compare with the first location. What is x? 99. What is element present at the first location? It is 77. Are they equal? No. Then we again go to the next pass, that is third pass. In third pass, we are going to compare x with the A of 2, second location. The element present at the second location is what? 33. So, we compare 99 and 33. Are they same? No. So, we again go to the next pass. Now, next position is position A of 3. We again compare X with the A of 3. Our X is 99 and the element present at the third location of the array is the 99. Are they same? Yes. So, our search is successful. We find 99 at the third location. Next example. Now this is the example of linear search, unsuccessful search. See, 90 is not present in the list. But how you can write into the exam? solution. Let us see that. So if you want to solve the 90, first store the 90 in some variable like x. In past one, we compare x with the first location, means zeroth location. So what is x 90? What is the element present at the zeroth location of array? It's 10. Are they same? No. So we go to the next pass, that is pass 2. In pass 2, we consider the next location, that is a of 1. So we compare x and a of 1. What is x 90? What is element present at the first location? 20. Are they same? No. So we go to the next pass. In next pass, we again compare x with the next location, that is a of 2. What is x 90? What is the element present at the second location? It is 15. Are they same? No. Again we go to the next pass, fourth pass. Again we consider the next location. X is compared with the a of 3. What is x 90? What is a of 3? The element present at the third location is a 30. Are they same? No. So since we have find a 90 from 0th location to the last location, that is third location, we didn't found any match. So we print the output as, since end of the list is reached, x is equal to 90 is not found. This is the time complexity of the linear search. There are three time complexities: base case time complexity, average case time complexity, and worst case time complexity. These time complexity are measured as per the input. If we give the base case input, we will get the base case time complexity. If we give the average case input, we will get the average case time complexity. If we give the worst case input, then it is the worst case time complexity. If you consider the linear search, what will be the best case input? Best case input means what? You require the minimum comparison. Let us take an example. This is the array of 5 elements, 25, 17, 31, 1, 3, 13 and 2. So what will be the best output? If you want to search the 25, that is the element present at the 0th location. So we require only the one comparison, that is x, 25 and the a of 0. So this is the base input. So for base input 25, we require complexity. Complexity means the time complexity, nothing but the comparison. How many comparison you require? Only one. So base case, for base case input, that is 25, the complexity is O of 1. So if you want to find the 31, if you see the 31 is the average input for the linear search. Since 31 is at the middle position, so how many comparison will require to find the 31? You will require 3 comparisons. 25, 0th location, first location and the second location. So this is the average case time complexity of the linear search, that is O of n by 2. What is n? N is nothing but the size of the array. And the last is a worst case. What is the worst case input of the linear search? It should be the number which is at the last location, or it should be a number which is not present in the list. Take an example. If you want to find out 2 from the array, how many comparison you require? How many passes you require? 5 passes. We compare the 2 with a of 0, 1 pass, a of 1, 2 pass, a of 2, 3 pass, a of 3, 4th pass, and a of 4, 5th pass. Then you found the location of 2. If you want to find the 90 from this array, how many passes you require? Again 5. You again compare 90 with the a of 0, pass 1. Again compare 90 with the a of 1, pass 2. Again compare 90 with the 31, which is at a of 2, third pass. Again you compare 90 with the a of 3, that is 13, pass 4. And in pass 5, you again compare 90 with the element present at the fourth location, that is 2. And then you print the result. Since the end of the list is reached, your 90 is not found. So you can see that the element present at the last location, or element not in a list, having all the comparison, we have to perform all the comparison, all 5 comparison. So since this is an array of size 5, we require 5 comparison. If this array is of size n, then we require n comparison. So worst case time complexity of the linear search is O of n. These are the advantages of the linear search. Linear search is simple. It is easy to implement as compared to binary search, and it can be applied on sorted as well as unsorted list. So, in binary search, there is a restriction. Binary search is a technique we can only perform on the sorted array, not on the unsorted array. So, this is the advantage of linear search, that it can be applied on sorted as well as unsorted. But there should be a still disadvantage of linear array. That's why there is another searching method, binary search. So, what is that disadvantage? Disadvantage of linear search is it is slow. It has more time complexity. As we have seen that in unit 1, we should select the algorithm that should have the less time complexity. We have to reduce the time complexity. So, linear search is very slow. So, therefore, we are not using the linear search to find the element. We are using the binary search instead of linear search to make the searching algorithm fast. We will learn the binary search in the next video. Thank you.